Welcome, mappers. Today, I'm going to be talking to you about one of the important concepts in Campaign Cartographer 3+, namely the command prompt. For some users, the command prompt is this mysterious entity they don't really know much about and don't know what to do with. While for other users, the command prompt is one of the more important tools in Campaign Cartographer. It is the way they can get really productive and doing the things they actually want to do in an easy manner. So today, I'm going to talk a little bit more about the command prompt, where it is, how to use it, and so on. So, as you can see, I already have Campaign Cartographer loaded up on my screen. And to start, the command prompt is this line down at the bottom here. You can see right now, it reads command and null and not much else. So, what is the command prompt? Well, the command prompt is kind of the interface between you and Campaign Cartographer. If Campaign Cartographer wants you to tell you something, it will use the command prompt in most cases. So, it's very important for you as a user to keep an eye on the command prompt to see what Campaign Cartographer expects of you at any given point in time. And that brings me into the two main uses of the command prompt. The first use of the command prompt is to basically look at it and see what Campaign Cartographer 3+ wants, and then provide the appropriate inputs. The second way of using it is to actually type full commands yourself on the command line and use the command line in a way to tell Campaign Cartographer what to do. So I'm going to start with the first example, basically having Campaign Cartographer using the command prompt to tell you what it expects from you next. Just start with a simple example. I'm going to click the line tool and look at the command prompt now. It says first point. So this is Campaign Cartographer telling you it now needs the first point of your new line. So I can just click to place that and move my mouse. And see that I have this line following me now. And again, if I look at the command prompt, it now says next point. It expects the next point. Okay. And click to place the next point. It still says next point. And click and click. And I right click when I'm done, just as always. So that's the basic operation of the command prompt. It tells you what it expects from you. And in this case, I didn't have to type anything at all. I used my mouse, placed the points, and the command prompt just told me what it expected from me next. So the command prompt doesn't always expect you to type something on the keyboard. It's just an information to you as the user. But it is important to pay attention to the command prompt. If not, you might forget a step in a command, for example, and what you tried to do simply didn't complete, didn't happen. For example, one of the more common mistakes I see is that people forget to complete the copy command when they try to copy something to the clipboard, and the command never finishes. So let's just try to copy something to the clipboard, just to see how that shows up, and we're going to paste it into some other software. So I'm just going to start with the photo as software where I can paste something, and go back to Campaign Cartographer. I go to edit and copy. Immediately the command line tells me select entities. Okay, zero picked. I'm going to click this nice logo here. Now it says one ticked. Okay. And as always, when we select entities in Campaign Cartographer, I right click and do it, and I'm happy. And the problem is that a lot of people just stop here and believe, okay, I've copied to the clipboard, I'm done. But I go to Affinity Photo and try to paste something right now. What happens? Actually, I cannot. I have to do this new from clipboard. Current contents of the clipboard cannot be used to create a new document. Wonder why that is. Well, that's simply because I didn't copy anything to the clipboard at all. Let's go back to Campaign Cartographer and look at the command prompt. Look! It still wants me to provide some information. In this case, the clipboard origin. Okay, this is a set of coordinates. I can just click anywhere to put this. Okay, now we can see Campaign Cartographer is happy. If the command line starts with command, it means that the current command has finished. Campaign Cartographer now awaits a new command. And the part in square brackets here is the previous command that was just finished. It just shows us this so we can repeat the last command if we want to. Let me now go here and go to paste. And voila, it pasted the image as I copied it. So that's just a lesson in why watching the command prompt is so important. If you ignore the command prompt and just go on like this, we thought we had copied to the clipboard. Well, we hadn't. So that's one important lesson. And let's get back to our line tool. Again, I click line. We can see that it asks for a point, first point. As before, I can click to place this point. Now, what does the command line ask for next? It asks for next point. Well, what is the next point really? Well, it is a coordinate in the map. When I click with the mouse somewhere, it means that it just places the point at that coordinate. So instead of just clicking in the map, I can use the command line and I can type the values. So let me just place it in the origin 0.0. So as you can see, the command line, when I type, it just fills in on the command line. Enter. Voila, it seems that 0.0 is right here. I can continue to place them. Let's say 100.100. And I'm done. So as you can see, the command line, when it expects input, it can be given in multiple ways. It can be given by sometimes clicking the mouse in the drawing, sometimes typing values. And it all depends on what is appropriate in the situation. Let's look at something different. Let's look at copying an entity in the map. So I click copy in map button. I select my image. I hit do it. And now it asks where to copy. Copy from point. Again, that's a coordinate. I'm just gonna click in the middle of the map, or the middle of the, and I can drag this around. Okay, but let's look at the command prompt again. It says place. That's just an instruction for me to place it somewhere. And again, it actually wants coordinates of where to place it. And it also gives me some extra modifier keys here. Shift. 15% rotation, or sorry, 15 degrees rotation. Shift plus control is freeform rotation, and control is scaling. So here the command prompt tells me what I can do right now. So let's try doing that. Oops, I the control it seems, but again, let's just hit shift. You can see I can rotate it and hold on control. I can scale it. Control shift is just free rotation. So, and I can click place it. But again, just as we did with the line tool, why don't I try typing in, let's try the coordinates 50.50. You can see they appear on my command line right here. Hitting enter, ding, and we can see the image was placed at the selected coordinate. So again, I use the command line to see what campaign cartographer expects from me, and I use the keys listed on the command line to actually manipulate the drawing, and I use the command line to type in the destination of the image, and I also use the mouse to click to place the image. So again, the command line is the interface that allows you and CC3 Plus to communicate with each other. Campaign cartographer will tell you what it wants, and you can then provide the appropriate values. So again, always keep a look at the command line. If it does not say command here, it means that the command you are in the middle of has not been finished yet. You are in the middle of doing something, and campaign cartographer wants something from you. Only when it says command here is the current command done. So, there is one thing I haven't addressed yet, and that's the floating command prompt. You can see at my mouse cursor, the same text command pop as you can see down here, hovers at my mouse cursor. That's because I have the floating prompt turned on. And the floating prompt is a great way to put the command line a bit more in your face, so you actually notice when campaign cartographer wants something from you. The text at the mouse cursor is also slightly expanded from the text down here, so the information may be a bit more verbose. But again, if I click the line tool, you can see that at my mouse cursor it says select start of line, right click to cancel, while at the bottom here it just says first point. But the instructions are the same, it's just that the instruction at the mouse pointer is a bit more verbose. Clicking once says select next point of line. Right click to finish. Okay, right click. Again, if I try to copy something in my map, you can see it gives a bit of information. Click on edges to select and such things. Select, do it, select point to copy from, and it gives me the same shortcut keys. So you can see the floating prompt that hovers along my cursor and the prompt at the bottom of the screen are the same. They are asking for exactly the same information. It's just that the floating prompt is sometimes a bit more verbose about it. You can turn the floating prompt on or off through tools options, and you have display floating prompt. Display expanded text makes it a bit more verbose. If you turn this off, the floating prompt will more mirror the exact command prompt. Expanded text gives you a bit more information about what you are doing. Personally, after having worked with campaign cartographer for many years, I do not like to have the floating prompt on when I work normally, but it's a great tool for a beginner in campaign cartographer 3+, because it keeps it in focus and makes sure you see it at all times. And with the floating command prompt, it's the same thing as with the command prompt, as long as it starts with the word command and then previous command in square brackets, you are not in the middle of a command. But if it says anything else, it's because it's asking for information from. So, that's how campaign cartographer communicates with you through the command prompt. But there is a secondary use for the command prompt, and that is to actually type commands yourself. Previously, I clicked the line button and I drew a line like this, and I was done. And I clicked the copy button, copy the line, do it, and I place it. So, all of that is fine. But you can also type the commands directly on the command line. And again, to type a command, you should not be in the middle of another command. So as long as it starts with the word command, as I pointed out a lot of times now, it's ready to accept a new command. And if I want to draw a line, I happen to know that the command for drawing a line is line. So just type in line. This is a command. Hitting enter, and I'm into the line drawing command. Typing the command at the command line is exactly the same as clicking on the button, but there are some commands in Campaign Cartographer that either don't have buttons, or, as you might be aware of, there's a lot of add-ons to Campaign Cartographer, and not all commands from all add-ons are available in all menus. So sometimes it's easier to just type the command yourself rather than trying to find the correct add-on and find the correct command. And for almost every action in Campaign Cartographer, there is a command you can type on the command prompt. Again, if you want to delete something, another command is era, it's short for erase. So I type era, enter, and okay, and delete them. And again, typing the command in on the command line is no different from clicking on the button. You go straight to using the command immediately. It's not a special mode or anything. It's just a shortcut. For example, if I want to use the list command, you find the list command on info list. Find information, the list. I often just type list on the command prompt instead. There's no different. You get the exact same command. It's just that in some cases it's faster to just type it on the keyboard instead of actually going to find it in the menu. And commands typing from the keyboard, like when I type line, still asks for information via the command prompt, but as I pointed out, this is no different from the commands or the requests it made when I clicked the button. So you shouldn't be scared of typing a command on the command line. Just, if you know the command, just type it in there, and if you type something bad, a command that doesn't exist, this command doesn't exist, Campaign Cartographer just gives you a simple error message. It's not like you're going to do anything horrible bad by typing a bad command. It's just a quick way of accessing the functionality of Campaign Cartographer 3+. Okay, thank you for watching, and have a nice day.